Hi guys, welcome to XXX. You're probably here because this error pops up when you use HandBrake to rip a DVD on your computer. So how to solve the problem in 2022? First, check your DVD to see if there are any serious scratches or damage. If not, the reason should be the copy protection on your purchased DVD, and this protection can stop HandBrake from creating a digital copy. So in today's video, I will show you three different solutions to fix the problem. Hope this will help. Solution 1 is to download libdvdcss, a free library available to access and read CSS protection. And the latest version of libdvdcss is 1.4.3, which was released last year. To download it, you just need to open this URL I found, and move to here. As you see, there are two versions of 1.4.3 for you to choose, the 64-bit and the 32-bit, so just choose the one corresponding to your Windows system. And then it will jump to a GitHub page, and here we click on Download. In the next step, copy the downloaded libdvdcss2.dll and paste it into HandBrake installation folder. Generally, the default path of HandBrake is disk C to program file to HandBrake. Then it will work fine for you to rip a DVD. It has to be noted that my HandBrake version is the latest 1.5.1. And I've seen a discussion on Reddit that the libdvdcss file not working when they tried to rip a newly released DVD with HandBrake 1.5.1. So if you meet this situation too, where you can choose the old 0.9.9 HandBrake instead of the latest one, because the developer of HandBrake have done a lot to make sure their program does not contain any kind of copy protection in recent years. So you can try this option if you failed to rip a DVD with the latest 1.5.1. Okay, now is the second solution I offered. Use other DVD rippers to rip your DVD. The reason is simple, HandBrake isn't developed for ripping discs and doesn't support encrypted DVDs. And there are lots of other products designed to rip DVDs, like MakeMKV. And what I used is a paid software called Winx DVD Ripper. You can directly rip a DVD to MP4 with it. For me, it's a cost-effective product for it saves a lot of time, and if you just need to convert a small number of DVDs, then the trial version is enough for you. The last solution is the easiest one, but there is a prerequisite. You have downloaded the latest version of VLC on your computer because this method will use a library from VLC. So now we just need to follow this, check the tools at menu bar and click on Preferences. Then head to Advanced Option, and here, tickle on Disable LibDVDNab. Then you just need reopen HandBrake, and it should be smooth for you to rip a full DVD. That's all for today's three solutions to solve HandBrake no valid source found error. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below, and I will answer them for you once I see them. And thank you for watching. Have a nice day.